Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to combine documents from different apps into a single PDF. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Say you have a document in Pages, but you also have a table or chart in Numbers, and maybe some images from somewhere else. And you want to have a single document, a single PDF, that then you can distribute or send to somebody. Well, you can combine PDFs pretty easily. You don't have to do it using the apps that you're creating these documents in. You can keep all of the documents in separate apps. And then you can export them as PDFs and merge them together to create your final document. So as an example here, I have a bunch of different documents using different apps. Let's start here with this report here in Pages. So this is a two-page report and this is going to make a part of my final PDF. So in Pages here, I'm going to go to File, Export to, PDF, and I'm going to export this out and save it in the same location, but it will have .pdf after it instead of .pages. We also have a longer text report here in Pages. Let's export that out as well. Now I have a Numbers document, and this actually has two different sheets in it. So I'm going to end up with two different pages here. So let's export to PDF. And if I look at that PDF here, you can see it's got two pages in it, one from each sheet. I also have a Keynote document. It's an organizational chart just on a single slide. So let's export this as PDF. Now if I'm worried about how this is going to appear on the PDF, I could always, instead of choosing Export to PDF, go to Print, and then from there I could see a preview of what it would look like, and then use PDF, Save as PDF here. Let's say in addition to those documents, I've got something on the web, maybe a report that's generated that I want to include in my PDF. As a stand-in for that, I'll just use this page of US Census data. So here in Safari, I can export this page as PDF and save that out to the same location. Alright, so let's start combining these. Now let's assume I want to keep all the individual PDFs around. So I'll start by taking one of these, let's say the very first one, and make a duplicate of it. And that'll be the file that we're going to create. So here it's created and it's just called the graphic report copy. I'm going to hit return and rename it as combo report. And then I'm going to double click it to open it up in preview. So we're going to use preview to combine these documents. Let's just shrink this window down a bit and I can move it over here to the right. Now I've got in this new document here the two pages from the combo report. I want to go and add some things to it. Let's start by adding one of those pages from the Numbers document. So I'll open up that PDF here and let's shrink that window a bit so we can see both kind of at the same time. And I could select any one of the pages here on the left. If you don't see the left sidebar, you can go here and choose Thumbnails. And I could drag this and I can put it anywhere I want in here. I can put it before the first page, between these two, or let's put it here after page two. So now we have page one, two, and three, even though the numbering doesn't show that here. Now let's close that and let's go and grab that long report. Double click on that. And I'm going to grab all the pages here. So I'll select the first one, go to the bottom, and shift click to select all five. Then I'm going to drag all of them here to the bottom. And now you can see it's added five pages here. Now let's go grab that other page from the Numbers document. I'll select it here. Let me drag it over and I'll scroll to the end here and drop it after the last one. Let's grab that Keynote organizational chart. So I'll go into that. I have to show thumbnails on this one. There it is. Let me shrink this down and I will drag it here to the end. And finally, there's all of that census data in here. So that's a fairly big document, but it's a single page. So I'm going to select all of that here. And you know what I'm going to do? I don't really want all this extra stuff here. So I'm going to use the markup tools, do a selection there, and I'm going to just draw a box around the part that I want. And then I'm going to crop like that. Select OK. Now I'm going to drag and drop this to the end of this document here. And you can see that's exactly what I get. So now here's my document as a PDF. And I could save this now would be a good idea. I've got these two pages. I've got this one. I've got all these different ones here, all as a part of a single document. I can move things around. So say if this organizational chart needs to come earlier, I can drag it up and put it above here. So I can move all these around as individual pages. And notice that some of these pages are horizontal, some of them are vertical. The PDF doesn't care. It'll have all of those. It's not great for printing, but if the idea here is to distribute a PDF and be paperless, then there's no reason you can't combine different page sizes inside of a single PDF document. So now the one thing we're missing is a cover page. We've got one of those here too. I've got a cover sheet. Let's open that up in Pages. I will export that to PDF. And let's put that at the very beginning. Now since I want the whole document and I don't need to preview it, I don't need to open it up inside of Preview. I can just drag the PDF right into here and it will add it. So in a lot of cases that might be easier. If you have a bunch of PDFs and you just want to put them all in the order that they appear, you can just drag and drop them into the sidebar here without opening them up in Preview first. Now let's save this document. And you can see here I still have the weird page numbering. It recognizes this as page 1 and then this is page 1 and 2 and then 1 and then 1 through 5. It kind of keeps the page numbers that were originally for each page when they were in their own documents. But if I close this and then open it up again here, you can see now it has renumbered everything. Those numbers are kind of nice because they help you see things a little clearer when you're compiling the document. But in the end, they're all just really in this one long big document now that's a PDF from 5 different documents. And I can keep adding to it. I don't have to do this all at once. So I have this combo report open and let's add something else. Let's say we wanted to add an image. So you don't have to convert it to a PDF first. Just by adding it here to the list, it'll add it as a page in the PDF. So I can drag an image, just about any format will do, right here and it adds it as its own page. And now that's part of the PDF. So I can save here and close the document. If I reopen it, you could see it's there just as a page on the PDF that just happens to just have that one image there. Another way you could bring documents in is to go to Edit, Insert, and then Page from File. So I can grab a page. Let's grab this org chart here. You can see I've started over again and it inserted that file in between these. So let me undo that, go to page 2, and the great thing about using Insert Page from File, seems like it's a longer process, but you can select multiple files. So let's grab the break-even analysis. I'm going to hold the Command key down, grab the cover sheet, grab the long report, and the org chart, and the census data, and then open. And it's going to add all of those things in here. Now what I can do is use another technique, going to Contact Sheet, and easily rearrange things like I want. And Contact Sheet is really useful because you can see everything at once and just drag and drop to put things in the right order. So let's put the cover sheet here at the beginning. And I can correct any other things that are in the wrong order as well. You can also use the cover sheet view to drag and drop things. So let's take that image in there. We couldn't use image in that insert command, but we can drag and drop it here. So now that's in there and we can put that where we want. And let's go back to thumbnails view here. And you can see everything is organized just like I want it. And you're not just restricted to using the apps that I've shown. Anything can export PDF. Even if there's no export to PDF function in the app, you can always print and then use the PDF option there. So you can use documents from Microsoft apps, from other third-party apps, from all sorts of web pages. Anything that you can create a PDF with or an image with, you can then go ahead and create a combination PDF document by merging them together in Preview. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.